In this video, we're going to take a look at another one of my favorite new features with macOS Sonoma. This is the screensavers and wallpapers. It is not only screensavers that Apple introduced, new screensavers, but we can now morph these screensavers to our wallpaper or desktop picture on the Mac. Let's take a look at these screensavers and wallpapers on the Mac. Let's go to my Mac. So I'm on my Mac here. This is a MacBook Air and it's running macOS Sonoma. Let's first take a look at these screensavers and then we'll see how we can activate them instantaneously so we can try them out. And we're going to look at how we can morph them into our desktop here, as I mentioned in the introduction. To find our screensavers, these new screensavers, what we do is we go down to our system settings. When I select this, what we need to do is go over to screensaver here. From here, you're going to see all of our screensavers, and we have a number of new screensavers. Now, if you've been using a Mac for a while, you know that the Mac has had older screensavers. They're still here. You're going to see them down at the bottom. So if you like the older screensavers, you can still use those. But we have a number of new screensavers that I think you're really going to enjoy, especially when you see how you can morph them into the desktop picture or wallpaper. So these are the new screensavers. What I would like to do is I would like to sample these. I want to try them out. I want to see what they look like. How can I do that? The next thing that I would recommend doing is setting up a hot corner to start your screensaver. This is nothing new, but it does make it easy to try out these screensavers. If I go and click on a screensaver here, you're going to see it doesn't really do anything. What I have to do is I have to wait for my Mac to go to sleep. I don't want to do that. I want to see what it looks like. So what you need to do is go over to your desktop and dock. And then down at the very bottom, you're going to see hot corners. Again, this is nothing new. I select it. And then you're going to see we have four corners. What we're able to do is set each one of these corners to do something. So in my case, what I'm going to do is set the upper left-hand corner to start the screensaver. So I just go over here, select this, and say start screensaver. So now when I move my cursor in the upper left-hand corner, what it's going to do is start the screensaver. So let's go back over to my screensavers here. And we're just going to start with the Grand Canyon here. I select it. You may need to download it. I'll talk about that shortly, but this one is downloaded, so I just select it, and I want to see what this looks like. I just move my cursor in the upper left-hand corner here to the very corner of the display, and now we can see that screensaver. And you can see it's like an aerial shot. We're traveling through the Grand Canyon, much like what we see on the Apple TV, if you have an Apple TV. Let's try out another one. I just wake it back up. Let's go over to New York. I select it. And again, I just go to the upper left-hand corner. And now we're flying above New York. Now you may need to download these. Let's go over to Los Angeles. I've not downloaded this one. When I select this, you're going to see up at the top here, it is going to start downloading. If I no longer want to download it, I click on the X and the button turns into download. Now what I'm going to do is put it on my favorite. I like this coral one here. So I'm going to select this. Let's just take a quick peek here. I think that is really beautiful. I really like that one. Move my cursor, it brings it back. In fact, I like that so much. What I would like to do is make that my wallpaper, my desktop picture. Well, we can have the screensaver morph into that desktop picture. How do we do that? Well, you're going to see up at the top here, when we're looking at our screensaver here, you're going to see it says show as wallpaper. All I need to do is just turn this on, and now you're going to see that it is showing this as my wallpaper. But that's not where it gets really cool. Let's go and start the screensaver. What I'm going to do is hide this here or close this window here. And now I'm just working on my computer. I let it go to sleep. Let's just go and put it in the upper left-hand corner. We're going to let it go to sleep or start the screensaver. It's going to start the video. And we can see it just started from where it was. We're just traveling through the ocean here. And now when I wake up my computer, watch what happens. Where this video stops and it's going to slowly stop, it's going to morph into my desktop picture or wallpaper. So now I just move my cursor here and it's slowing down. And now that is my new desktop picture. I go back to sleep, it's going to start back up, and now I wake it back up, it's going to slow down, and it's going to make that my desktop picture. So while I'm working, I'm not going to have any moving pictures, but if I stop working, it's going to go back into the screensaver. I'll show you how you can set the time or how long it is before it goes to the screensaver shortly. So that's how we can morph that into our desktop picture. We can do this with any one of these aerial screenshots. We can't do this with the Ventura or Monterey. If we go over to New York, watch what happens. I click on it, we have our New York skyline, and we're going to take another look at this because I think it's really cool. Now we're flying over New York, and when I move my cursor, it stops at that spot, and that is my desktop picture. Now, eventually, this is a movie, eventually what it will do is it will start back over. So you could let it go for about a minute or so, and then it will start back over. So it's not a 24-hour loop. That would take up the entire hard drive. Okay, so that's how you can morph that wallpaper into your desktop. But we have one more trick. When you are, I'm going to bring it back to my coral. I just really like that coral one. So I'm just going to go to screensaver here, and we go over to coral. We can put the clock, when it's in screensaver mode, in that screensaver so we can see what the time is. How do we do that? Well, basically, we just go back into our Mac here. We wake it up. It's going to slow down. We go to our system settings. And then from here, what we need to do is go over to our lock screen. This is also where we can set how long it is before our screensaver starts. I select this. And then what we need to do is just go to our show large clock. By default, it is set to show on the lock screen, but I can also have it set for on the screensaver and lock screen. So I'm going to do that, select this, and now when I go into the screensaver mode, bring my cursor to the upper left-hand corner, we can see that clock up at the top of my display. I wake my computer up, and that clock disappears. Now it's also going to be on the lock screen. Let's go over to my lock screen. The lock screen will also show the screensaver. So what I'm going to do is go over to my Apple menu here, and then we're going to go over to my lock screen. So I'm just basically going to lock my computer. So now it's just going to be traveling through there. We have the clock there, and if we look down at the bottom, we also have our logins. So I'm going to log back in under John Appleseed. Use Touch ID, and now it's going to slow down. Up at the top, we can set when we want our screensaver to start. I have it set for 1 minute. I was experimenting with this. It's a little quick. I like to use that hot corner trick. This is how I was starting the screensaver. Hot corner is much better. So I'm going to slow this down. We're going to set it for 5 minutes. Now, if you're in an office environment, you may want to also lock the screen. This will only start the screensaver, but it's not going to lock it. What you can do is set it to require a password when it goes into the screensaver mode or when the screensaver begins. Mine is going to require a password after 5 minutes. So what you may want to do is set this for 1 minute. As soon as you walk away, or you could even go immediately, but as soon as you walk away from your computer, right now, 5 minutes later, the screensaver will start, and the only way that anyone will be able to get into my computer is if they know what the password is. The last thing I want to show you with the screensavers is we can also set them to shuffle. So we can shuffle our aerials. So I could shuffle all of them, or I can just shuffle the landscape ones, the underwater ones, the cityscape ones, or even just the earth ones. So depending on which ones you like, which category you like, you can shuffle them. So that is one of my favorite new features with macOS Sonoma, our screensavers and wallpapers. Not only do we have new screensavers, which are aerial shots like the Apple TV, but we can also morph them into our desktop picture or wallpaper. I personally will probably be using these screensavers on my personal device. I generally don't use screensavers. I just have the display go to sleep, but maybe for the first 5, 10, 15 minutes, I might have these screensavers on just because I think they're really cool. So that is how the new Screensavers and Wallpaper work with macOS Sonoma.